Bollywood superstar Shah Rukh Khan, who is gearing up for his next release, Happy New Year, which is releasing October 24, participated in one-to-one Q&A session hosted by IANS. In an exclusive talk, SRK speaks his heart out about his upcoming film, his production house, Red Chillies, and also about his future plans. Watch his uncut and exclusive interview here.
So the process has started, the release process has started. So what are your thought process as an actor, also as a producer?
I have no thought process as a producer. I've got such a wonderful team to handle that. I'm never part of any other process apart from creating the film. So my processes are with Farah, with the actors, with some creativity of the film, whichever aspect I'm called upon to do so. In every film, not only the one I produce.
About the film coming out and, you know, the
it's
reaction.
Nice. As an actor, I'm happy. I hope people like it. I think it's a fine film. I think we've made a good effort, and it's a fun, happy family film. And I always wanted to make one film because I've always been talked about as someone who makes families happy, the mothers and daughters and sisters and everyone. So yeah, this is like a quintessential Bollywood film where on Diwali, when you want to feel happy and celebrate, hopefully this will bring some cheer to everybody.
So can we say that Happy New Year with you and Farah, it will bring happiness to you and cheer for your fans also when it releases on Diwali?
I think the films are made only to make whatever kind of film, from Swades to Happy New Year. I make films with some aspect which will make people like, give them hope, give them some positivity. I've never done a film which is really just a film, I think. You know, I've tried always to say a message, some good thing, some interesting aspect. So hopefully this will also, and Farah's a very fine director, she's larger than life. We as producers, I think, have grown over the years.
And, in what way?
You know, in terms of technology, in terms of presenting films, in terms of marketing, Red Chillies. People keep saying it to me, but I think it's Red Chillies who does all this. So we have some wonderful set of people who learned, you know, on the field. While making films, you know.
In terms of technology, what new technologies have you used in this?
Oh, we have some amazing stuff here. Whether it's the visual effects, whether it's the technology that we've used for the sequences in fight, I think have never been used before.
All done by your own company?
By our own company, completely. You know, we learn it. What we learn in the last film, we try to, you know, make it perfect in the next one. So what we learn in Chennai, Ravan, we've tried to make it perfect. And it'll show results, you know, when you see that one or two shots on those buildings, you know, falling down. I think they're quite awesome, and it's as good as any international film can show you. And that's for me, as a producer, is the biggest eye. Not the film, not the monies, not the business. For me, it is that, can I create something which Indian cinema is wanting to see in terms of technology? There are few people, you know, see, films work anyways, the story is good, whatever. But technology is what we can control as producers. So we like to bring that in. So hopefully all that, and when you see the bigness, the magnum opusness of this film, you know, it'll make you feel very proud. I think every Indian very proud that, oh wow, technologically, you know, the Dolby, THX, 5.1, 7.1, the sound, everything will be fantastic. And that's something that you can control as a producer. And I'm, in my office, the only thing, that's all I say, is the quality part of a filmmaking, which we can control, should be of the highest order. The results you can't control, the business you can't control, so you know, everybody does their best. So yeah, that part will, I think, will enhance storytelling.
When you had come for HT Summit, I had interviewed you very short. There you had talked about setting up a studio. So what about that plan?
I don't know, I don't have land, I don't have money to buy it. And I can't do it if I don't have the money. So one of these days, one of these nights, when we have that money or when we have that backing, I don't like to do it borrowing money. So one of these days I'll make a big film and we'll make big money, and then yeah, I've been telling my CEO Venky sir and everybody will be very thrilled, make a great studio. And it's not, see, a studio is not a money making, when I say the physical studio, you know, stages and all, it's not a money making proposition. But I think we deserve it as Indians to have the best studios in the world. Yeah, you have Yash Raj.
Can be a legacy also.
No, I don't work for a legacy. I need to make something that you know, enhances filmmaking in this country. You know, you have Yash Raj, you have another couple maybe. But I think you need more. You're the highest film producing nation in the world. Give the unless you have the facilities to strive for excellence, you'll never get excellence. So you can't keep on saying, I want to do something excellent. But if you don't have things helping you out, and a good studio, a good sound stage, a good post-production unit will always enhance our films.
Okay, Happy New Year. We are coming to Happy New Year. This will be your first release after, I think, over half an year.
Chennai was when? Yeah, now August.
Yeah.
So, not even 1 month. Yeah.
1 year or 3 months.
It's coming on in October.
Yeah, September,
right?
October. One year, 2 months, yeah.
Yeah, so say 14 months. So why such a long gap?
I make beautiful long films and I pay attention to them. I just don't make any other film. I like
not
making
a
one film.
Decision.
No, I make one. This is a big film. This is a 170-day shooting film. It's a very big film. And you have 7 artists. So the director is available. I think some of the lead artists should be available. So Vivan is new. He was more or less, but Boman, Abhishek, and Deepika, they're all busy actors. And you can't take away from what they have their professional commitments for. Some of them have gone out of their way to give us dates. So I think it's only fair that I hang around. So I think it's just important for me to be available. And I do one film at a time. I can't do more than one film at a time. I'm through with that. I've never done, actually, you know, it's 25 years, I know about 50 films. So I've never been able to do more than two and a half films a year, even in the times when people used to do 12 films.
You have done 84 films according to IMDb.
Those are guest appearances, no? 55 is full-length films, which I think 55, 56. And I like to keep it that way. I enjoy doing one film, finishing it off, taking some time off, spending time with kids, then get on to the next one. It's very irritating to me. Khatam hua, dusra mein gaya, do pictures shoot kar, I can't do that anymore. I've not been able to do that for 5-6 years now. So whether it was Swadesh, then Ravan, then Dawn, Jab Tak Hai Jab. I like to do a film once. This is a big film. This is a 170-day film. That's nearly half a year. So, you know, when you, half of year means spread over a year, year and a half. So I'd rather sit down. I don't need to. I enjoy the process. I have other things to do as an actor. I can creatively, as a producer, take part in things. So
what would be your next venture and when are you planning to start that?
I'm starting Fan now. I was supposed to start it actually yesterday. But I requested them if I can have a 20-day break so that I can finish all this off. So I'm not, you know, subah jaake shooting karna or whatever. So Fan starts, then there's Rais, then there's Rohit Shetty next film. And there's another on the cards, but 2 or 3 are enough right now.
What kind we of work films like you're planning to make without you?
With
newcomers
all the,
or with new directors?
It's a mix. We have some directors who are kind of on the anvil, some directors who've already done some stuff, actors are being cast according to the director. So we have a whole department which is headed by Manish. And he's planning at least 2 or 3 films already, some small, some medium. A couple are with me, Rais is with me, Rohit is with me. So those 2 films are Achilles and co-production with XL, Rais. So we have 2 films with me and maybe another 3 if we can put on floors. It'll be nicer. I think we should concentrate. We have a big office now where everybody thinks they know how to make films. And it's important they stop making just my film. They make more films because I think in the last 12, 13 years that we've run the company, we are sort of ready to do it.
So you're kind of expanding?
Expanding means, no, not as a businessman. I think some of us have learned filmmaking as producers. And I think they need to find their own space, you know. But like if Karuna is producing this, maybe this is not the kind of film she wants to make. She wants to make a different one. Kareem wants to make a different one. Manish wants to make a different one. So we have enough producers in-house now who would like to, you know, I may not be able to participate in it. Now, Mr. Khan, you don't have to do it, but this is a good film to make. And I think over 12 years when you've collected a set of creative people, creative producers, you need to give wings to them. And I think we are in a position now, and hopefully with Happy New Year releasing, and if it does well, you know, we'll be in a position where we can try out different stuff. That's what producers should do, try out different stuff. And we always have our rider films with me in it. We have Rohit's film and Rais.
Wish you all the best
thank you,
in your endeavors, and thank you for being here.